Greetings. In this video, we're going to introduce you to the Vonage Contact Center's Omnichannel integration with Salesforce, leveraging Salesforce's external routing API. In that environment, all digital interactions will initiate within Salesforce and then immediately be handed over to the Vonage Contact Center for routing, so that all of the calls, chats, and emails that may come into this agent will all be routed by the Vonage Contact Center. Agents will have the ability to view that queue and any calls or digital interactions that are queuing for them from this personal wall board display within their contact pad. Over here, I have an instance of a customer who is going to chat to us. So here is the customer webpage. They're going to initiate a chat with us. I have this agent in an away state so that we can queue up the interaction, and you can see some of what happens when we are queuing. So let's get this started. Jason Newgarden is going to start a chatting session. He's going to interact with a Einstein chatbot that's going to do some pre-processing. He's looking for some product help. In this particular case, the only real option is to talk to an agent. So he gives us an identifying piece of data so we know who he is. And then we can actually do a data dip into Salesforce. We know the agent he's working with. We know that agent is logged in, just not in an available state. Would you like to live chat with them? And so Jason does want to chat, and he indicates so. And we will soon see that chat appear here in the queue for this agent. Now, I want to get a call launched and also into this queue so that you can see that interaction as well. So we will get this call here launched momentarily. I will get a call into the queue here so we can.
To discuss our great new products and services with your account manager, press 1. To speak to our.
So we'll press 1. We just want to get into them. Don't need to hear the queuing, and we will see now that this call is going to also be queuing. So we can see that there's a call in queue, there's also that chat in queue, and so I'm going to make myself ready here as an agent. And what's going to happen is we're going to place the call in first because we did prioritize the call based on the fact that a live telephone call requires more real-time interaction than chat. So the chat is still in queue. I can handle Jason appropriately. What is his issue? You know, maybe he wants pricing. He may want it for one of our specific products. So he was looking for some product information. I'm going to store that activity record to his contact record, but maybe I could also associate it to the product that he's interested in. So maybe he has an interest in our conversation analyzer product. We can save that, release that interaction, and immediately we are going to then be made available so that we can chat with this agent here. So we can now see that our chat interaction has popped in, and I can begin typing. And as an agent, you would then have the ability to do whatever is the appropriate processing. And while that is happening, I'd like to get an email launched into our queue here just to show the completeness of the omnichannel capabilities. So I'm going to quickly launch an email from my cell phone, and we should see that email pop into this queue here momentarily. So I can continue doing my chatting with this particular customer, and ultimately, I can get rid of, maybe end that chat. Okay. I want to wait until I do so. And there comes our email. And I wanted you to see that that is now hit our queue. And we would have the ability, depending upon how we set up agent capacity, to either allow this email to come in because we determine that an agent can handle an email and a chat simultaneously. In this case, we set up the capacity so that it was a serial transaction and the agent would not have both at once. So as soon as I end this chat, and release myself from the interaction. Close the chat down here. We'll get our agent window opened up to full screen. And as soon as I make myself ready, we will see that that chat now comes and is delivered to us right here as a case and pop to the screen. And in this particular case, Mr. Hinchcliffe needed his account reset. So he's all good. I reset the account. It's a product question. It's going to be saved to that case. So we can then save that and release that interaction. So that was a quick way that we went through three different interactions. One was a chat initiated in Salesforce. One was an email that was initiated in Salesforce. One was a phone call. All came into the same agent queue, were able to be answered by the agent. And as appropriate, we popped open the appropriate record to the agent desktop. Now, from a real-time perspective, we also have the ability within the Vonage Contact Center to manage and keep track of any calls and emails and chat activity that's going on within our center. We have the ability to see in real-time how many calls are offered and maybe queuing for the various queues. So in addition to all of the great capability within Salesforce, you also have the real-time capability within the Vonage Contact Center to keep track of all of the real-time information across channels. I hope that you found this useful. Thanks for watching.